Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, gentlemen of the press, this is meant to be a very brief remark, and I will make it so. Let me join my brother, the Right Honorable Speaker, to welcome our esteemed guests, our governors, the progressive governors. This is a special moment for us. This will be the first meeting between the leadership of the National Assembly of APC stock and our governors, the progressive governors. So this is a family affair. And indeed, on behalf of all my colleagues, the principal officers here, I welcome you to the National Assembly. It is a fact and a truism that our party, particularly our governors, did so well, worked so hard, assiduously to ensure that the leadership of the National Assembly emerged with little or no hitch in the 2019 leadership contests. We want to take this opportunity to thank you for that show of trust. We believe that you have done your part by giving us all the support that we needed. The ball is now in our court to keep this leadership in trust. And we intend to remain very resolute. We intend to remain very loyal to the party and the principles the party stands for. We intend to remain committed and dedicated to Nigerian ideals of making sure that Nigeria provides all the necessary services to citizens, and especially when it comes to the area of ensuring the security, safety, and welfare of citizens. When we emerged, without any doubt, we had a very bipartisan combination in the way and manner our elections took place. The APC provided the platform. Almost all the APC in the Senate and the House, in fact, voted along the line of ensuring that this time around the party produced the leadership without any adulteration, so to speak. But also the opposition parties, in the Senate particularly, the PDP and the YPP, have done so much to ensure that they give that kind of support. And I want to take this opportunity to be extremely practical, that so far in the National Assembly, the journey has been very, very good. We have been working in a very bipartisan manner, and all those things that we felt were very necessary to be achieved, the national interest, we have done so across party lines. I believe that this kind of partnership will continue. Finally, on this segment, it is necessary that the two levels, in fact, all the levels of government work together. We have certain issues that we cannot do alone at the national level. When we have to take out 11, 12, or 13, or even 14 million children out of school, off the streets, the federal government cannot do that alone. This is something that I think the two levels of government, particularly the states and the federal government, will have to work together. And the states, I want to assure our governors here, you have partners in the National Assembly. We believe that we can do far better, we can do more when we work together, and we are here representing the states. Actually, all of us belong to states. We don't belong to just federal government by chance. It's because we belong to state that we belong to federal government. And I believe that there is need for us to continue to have this kind of interaction, probably even more often, so that we are and continue to define and redefine the dynamics of how good governance can be engendered and sustained. Thank you very much. You are welcome.
Ceremonies will have the chairman of the forum sign our visitors register and aids to all our principals to please excuse them as they go into a closed door session. All aides can start moving out.